Hello, hi, my name is Nilesh. Sometimes we encounter a feature in a product when we are not looking for it. This happened to me recently when I was using Lens. I use Lens, which is an IDE for visualizing the state of a Kubernetes cluster, and I've been using it for quite a while. Recently, I encountered or discovered a feature in this product which allows us to deploy Helm charts. Helm is a package manager for deploying applications on Kubernetes, and I have been using Helm for quite a long time. Let's see how we can use the Lens IDE to deploy Helm charts without using the Helm CLI. Here I have the Lens application opened, and I am connecting to one of the Kubernetes cluster where I want to deploy the Helm chart. If we go into the Helm section, we can list down all the charts that are available for us to deploy. We can see things like external scaler, Azure Cosmos DB, there is KEDA, KEDA add-on HTTPS, and so many others commonly used. This can be coming from Bitnami repository, or it can come from other repositories as well. Like the Azure Marketplace is available. We can deploy these things like console, which comes from the Azure Marketplace. And there are also other repositories. So this is an extensive list of charts. A chart is a collection of the manifest files, which comes with various settings, and we can override some of these settings. Without the Lens IDE, the way I would deploy Helm chart was using the Helm command line or Helm CLI. Here is an example where I have used Helm to deploy RabbitMQ for one of my application. And we can see from line number 8 till 14, how do we apply the Helm upgrade command, or how do we use the Helm upgrade command to install the Helm chart. In this case, we are using the RabbitMQ, which is coming from Bitnami repository. And then we upgrade or install this particular chart with a specific version of 10.2.1. And we provide additional things like the username, password that has to be used, and some additional settings, which is applied as part of the Helm deployment. Now we can do the same thing using this particular Helm plugin or Helm feature of the Lens IDE. Let's go and search for Prometheus, which is a commonly used observability tool on Kubernetes or with Kubernetes. And I have used this Prometheus operator in the past. So although it says deprecated and this chart will be renamed, this is coming from the Prometheus community repository. And I'm going to use this as an example here. When we click on Prometheus operator or any specific Helm chart from these available charts, we will get to see the details on the right hand and how to apply this chart if we were to apply this using the Helm CLI or Helm command line interface. Without going through the Helm command line interface, we can do it in graphical manner, and that is what we are going to see in this quick demonstration. Let's wait for all the details to be populated. So here we can see that current version of this chart, which is deployed or which will be deployed, is 9.3.2, and there are previous versions available for us to choose. And we also get other details associated with this particular Prometheus operator. Now let's assume that I want to go ahead and install this. I can click on this blue install button here, and it will give me in the terminal window here the option to look at what are the different parameters I can override. This is similar to providing a Helm values.yaml file, where the charts, they come with default values, and if we wish, we can override those values with our specific overrides. So once I click on the install, I will get the list of those manifest files. Let's increase this here and see what all different parameters or what all different manifests that would be applied as part of this particular chart to our Kubernetes cluster. So here we can see that the selected chart is shown in the chart section, the version, namespace, and if we want, we can give a name, optionally a name for this release. So let's say I want to give the name as Prometheus for this. And then we see all the different values that will be applied. If I want, I can override any of this. Let's say, for example, the default rules will be alert manager will be enabled at CD. Kubernetes will be scraped using the Prometheus scraper, and various other parameters which are required for running the Kubernetes for running the Prometheus operator are set here. And same way, there are some global parameters. I can enable or disable any of these. So let's say I don't want this alert manager. I can make this instead of true, I can change it to false. But in this case, I want to go ahead with the current settings. So let's go and say install, and it will install or it will apply this chart to our Kubernetes cluster. Once this finishes, we can go and look under the releases section. So the charts are like the available charts which can be deployed on the Kubernetes cluster, and then releases are the deployed version of that chart. So it is something similar to the Docker and containers, where image is like a template, and then we have a container which is a running instance of that. So here we can see this chart is deprecated, error is thrown, and if we try, let's try a different one, because it looks like this is not allowing us to install the deprecated one. So let's take the Prometheus operator, or let's go with the default, this one, the kube-prometheus-stack. This also comes from Prometheus community, and the version of that is 48.3.1. So we will do the same thing where we go and click the install button, and this will allow us to install this. This comes with the Kubernetes manifest, Grafana dashboard, and the Prometheus scraper. So let's go and install this. I will not change anything. I will go with the default, and once the manifest files are loaded here, I will click the install button. Let's hit install, and it's installing. I forgot to give the name here, or give the name here in the optional section. Let's see what is the name that it gives by default. Okay, the chart with the release name kube-prometheus-stack and a dynamically generated number has been successfully created. If we go into the releases section here, we should be able to see that kube-prometheus-stack is installed, and under the name we can see that. So the chart which is used is kube-prometheus-stack, and we can see the details here. So if I click on this, it will show us the details related to this particular release. And same way, we can see that there is the AKS managed SCADA, MyDapper extension, and RabbitMQ, which have been deployed previously. This I had deployed using the Helm CLI, whereas the kube-prometheus-stack I installed using Lens. And we can see all the values here that the user supplied, or that were used during this particular installation. If I click only the user supplied values, it will show the user supplied value. And once it is installed, it will also show us additional things like what are the service account, what is the secret, the config maps associated with this, the cluster roles, cluster bindings, the services, and various other things. If we want to verify this, we can go into the workload section or the network section and look under the services, because Prometheus will create some services which are related to the Prometheus account or Prometheus installation. And we can go and look at the Prometheus UI here, which runs on 9093 port. If we do a port forward, let's say to 9093 on our local port, on our local machine, to show to this or to redirect to this, we can see the Prometheus UI. So like this, we can see the Prometheus is working fine, and we can connect to the Prometheus UI, and we can also look at the various settings which are related to the Prometheus. We can get the status when it was enabled or when it was installed. And let's go and look at this Prometheus stack, which is running on port 80. Let's do another port forward and open it in our browser. That was the alert manager that we looked earlier. This is the Grafana login or Grafana screen which connects to the Prometheus. There is a default user and there is a default password. Let's try the default password if it works. So admin is the default user and prom-operator is the default password. And using this, we can again connect the Grafana dashboard to the Prometheus UI which is running. And if we go under the dashboard section here, this will by default show us things like compute resources. We can look at networking. We can look at the kubelet and we can look at some of these default settings which are connected or default dashboard which are connected or created for Grafana using that kube Prometheus operator. That is how we can use Lens to deploy a Helm chart into our Kubernetes cluster. Now, if we go back to the releases under the Helm, and if you want to delete this, we can select the release and we can then delete. Let's try that out. In terms of managing the complete lifecycle, we could upgrade or we could delete. Let's go and delete this. It will ask us for a confirmation to remove this particular Helm release. And once we click on the remove, it will run the uninstallation or uninstall command in the background. So here we can see that we can install, upgrade and delete the Helm chart, and we can create Helm releases without having the need to install the Helm CLI on our laptop. Using Lens IDE, we can manage that all in graphical manner. If you want to get hold of the Lens IDE, you can head over to k8lens.dev, and from there you can download the version which is specific to your particular operating system. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching this video. In case you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching once again. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.